Hey everyone, this is Neil Rodriguez, aka Yonke, and today's episode is on terrorism. Now we all know terrorism is bad, but do you ever wonder why we don't negotiate with terrorists? Personally, I think we can negotiate with terrorists, and today I'm going to show you how. Do you remember the game, What Time Is It, Mr. Wolf? We played it when we were in grades 1 and 2, basically, ages 5 to 7. The wolf faces the wall, and the goal is for the other kids to reach the wall and not get tagged by the wolf. The children chant, "What time is it, Mr. Wolf?" The child takes X amount of steps towards the wall based on the wolf's response. For example, 3 o'clock, which means take 3 steps. If the wolf says lunchtime or dinner time, he turns around and tries to tag someone to become the next wolf. The most exciting part of the game is the query from the children to the wolf. You never know, A, how many steps to take, B, whether you'll make it to the wall safe or not, and C, when it's feeding time. And here's where I introduce the terrorist protocol. So, step one, let feeding time be 100% transparent to all parties. For example, if X demand is not met, Y will occur. And let both parties participate in feeding time. That is, upon breach of contract, only the top leaders will be held accountable, meaning the people will either vote in favor of the opposition next election in a democracy, or the people will kill the terrorist leader and choose a successor. Step 2, assign threat levels, red, orange, yellow, green, blue, to all terrorist demands. For example, attack on a hospital is considered orange or red, depending on how critical that hospital is for that city, state, or country. Step 3, dates, times, and locations of upcoming terrorist events must be fully disclosed, confidentially, and on an ongoing basis. Any unsanctioned surprise attack by either party will be considered a breach of contract and will result in a feeding time consequences. Both parties must abide by international law. That is, they must respect international behavior, the laws of the sea, economic law, diplomatic law, environmental law, human rights law, and humanitarian law. If you want your terrorist party to be legitimate, you and your members must act legitimately. Failure to do so will result in a court case in the International Criminal Court and/or feeding time. Obviously, a court case is more preferred because it's more civil. Any questions?